Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and I discovered that the sword actually has two stages of weapon art. So this is going to be a tricky fight. So yeah, I mean, clearly there's the one stage, and after a few seconds, it powers up. My guess is that what you're supposed to do is hit the boss with the power... Oh! This got interesting. You can hold it. I was about to say, I'm guessing you have to wait until you charge it up against the boss. But no, you can hold it in advance. And now, of course, to run through this and run past the gargoyle thing that will not do anything to me because it isn't very accurate. Although we'll try to run in and attack me at some point, but who cares? Because we are going to boss fight with charged up sword. I know I promised a death montage, but, you know, let's actually start, as usual, with the normal fight. Also, I got the wind. I hope the wind's not too loud. I'm gonna have to probably edit that a bit. Alright, Yorm. Eat Stormblade! What? Ow! That worked out far worse than it did last time. Well, okay, I guess you get your promised death montage sooner rather than later. There we go. And then you charge up, and then you do it again. And that's where the fire thing comes in. Yeah! Oh! That's gotta hurt. I don't know if it deals- no, it doesn't deal any more damage. I have to use the weapon art. But, ow! Oh, it didn't hit me! Haha! You didn't hit me! You didn't hit me! I hit you! Ow! No, I don't. And I'm against a wall now. Okay. Just need to get myself... my bearing straight again, and... yeah! Oh, this is awesome. It's not quite... I'll detail some of my anti-hype afterwards, but for now, let's just finish this, shall we? So much for a death montage. Oh, that felt good. Anyhow, yeah, so as I was saying, well, that was a pretty cool fight. Just in that it went from being, I have this tank monster I can't deal with, to... five swings and it's down. I like that transition. It's a nice build-up. Nice setup feeling. You know, you're just going through and this insurmountable challenge, and then I get through it. That was awesome. We had a cool thing there. That was awesome. Okay, anyway, no, my anti-hype, though, is that I was thinking about the original Demon's Souls one. Granted, I haven't played Demon's Souls, so... kind of speaking a little bit out of turn, but the thing with Demon's Souls is this was a similar weapon there. Oops. Didn't need to do that. This was a similar weapon where you had the whole thing with the storm and then it went off and basically you're fighting these flying manta rays and the Storm King Sword, every one of its attacks would have that wind effect of the weapon art every single time you used it in that one boss fight alone, but you also, I'm pretty sure, saw them beforehand and there was this big deal that you're coming up to. Not to mention, there was an entire area before it that you kind of had a preview to it because of the Shrine of Storms, and the whole thing was building up to it over the course of several parts of the area because of the way Demon's Souls worked. It was like a multi-level system. So that was cool. This, I mean, it was kind of neat to have the Storm King sword, and that definitely helped a lot, made it a lot faster. It's also kind of, I don't know, maybe it feels a little disappointing to me just because I don't really care for the sword all that much. I mean, its weapon skill is okay, but it seems like it was rather specifically for that one boss fight. Yeah, I mean, see, you don't even have any attribute requirements for the sword. 0 and 0, that's it. It scales with strength and dex, but you don't need anything because everyone's supposed to use this. Which is fine, I mean, that makes sense. That's part of the boss fight. It's just that, I don't know, not having the foreshadowing or the setup feels a little bit disappointing to me. Also, it upgrades using Titanite scales, so nope, those go to the Wolf Knight Greatsword. Also, I should point out, I haven't really been pointing this out because I tend to do upgrades and then cut them out, but the way upgrading works for Twinkling and Titanite scales, like for Titanite chunks and Titanite shards, large Titanite shards, Titanite chunks, it goes 2, 4, 6, and then resets back to 2 of the next one up. However, for Twinkling Titanite and Titanite scales, it doubles every single time. So the first two, I mean, it's 3 because it's 1 for plus 1 and 2 for plus 2, and then it's 4 for plus 3. And as you can see now, it's 8 for plus 4. So I'm going to need a lot of Titanite scales in order to get the Wolf's Knight Greatsword to plus 4. I don't want to use any of them onto a sword that I don't really expect to use all that much. I mean, yeah, the Storm King thing was kind of neat, but it was specifically that boss fight. Unless there's something else, maybe, I don't know. Maybe I should play around with it a bit more. Just see how it works in other boss fights. The weapon art is kind of neat, but I really like the weapon art for the Wolf Knight Greatsword. So I don't see any reason not to use it. Anyway, I thought I should mention that because I was under the assumption that it was like, it just went up by one every time for Twinkling Titanite and Titanite scales, and I probably carried that forward, and that was incorrect. Also, just double check, did I give... I'm probably just going to level up and not really worry too much about anything. I am going to double check a couple things, though. Actually, before I level up, because this is the way we do things, story time first, that's what we do. Use story time first. Cinders of a Lord. Cinders of a Lord left by Yorm the Giant. If the lords will not return to their thrones themselves, let them return as cinders. Lonely Yorm became a Lord of Cinder to put the profaned flame to rest, knowing full well that those who spoke of him as Lord were quite insincere. Well, at any rate, kind of a sad story, apparently. Wanted to get rid of the whole profaned flame and didn't really do much. Yes, I have. What can I get for this? Yorm's Great Shield? Okay, I don't really care. As a lord, Yorm risked everything and fought unflinchingly as a one-man vanguard. Following the loss of the one he wished to protect, he forsook his shield. Oh. That's unfortunate. But that's pretty much in keeping with Dark Souls. Is there anything else that I'm missing? So, Yorm the Giant is also Yorm's machete. I don't really care about that. Is there anything else? No, and the only one I'm keeping is the Hollow Slayer great sword thing, which I don't know why I'm keeping that. I've been holding on to the Rotted Greatwood Sword for a while because I haven't been sure if I was going to use it for its greatsword, but I don't think I will. But I'm also not super desperate for souls, so I don't know.
Ah, most ill, fine kin, and oh, in.
Okay, whatever. Nothing new. So, we're going to have people to talk to. If we don't, then I'll just have skipped over to back to the Profane Capital, or maybe not even Profane Capital, I don't know.
Speak on our lord, no faithful.
Nope. Nothing new.
Till we meet him.
I almost don't think anyone's gonna talk, so, yeah.
Oh, what I'm... Alright, I... Goodbye.
Oh,
this...
Oh, what do you wish? You know, in I would be terrible. Have a pleasant journey, Champion of Ash.
Well, hasn't it been some time? I'm Leonard the Ringfinger. Remember me? I slipped you those red eyes some time ago. You're making quite an effort of it, so I thought you might like to know. If you yearn for a proper red eye orb, one that is uncracked, Then kill the Dark Wraith, survivor of the land swallowed by darkness. He has been a prisoner for many ages in the deepest cell in all Lothric. I can see it in your eyes. If you didn't invade, didn't pillage, whatever would you do? If you fancy up, then kill the... He has been... I can...
Well, that answers two questions. One, what is that other locked orb in the High Wall of Lothric? Or locked door, rather. And... two... How do you get a regular red eye orb? But I don't really care about that second one too much. Anyway, gonna level up and then go back to... Actually, no, I think I'm just gonna run around the High Wall of Lothric, hopefully find something unlockable, go there, unlock it. I'm trying to remember where it was now. Well, we'll deal with it when I get to it, so I'll cut back to that. All right, let's see if this did anything. And it did! We have a new area in the High Wall of Lothric to access. Suits of armor, eh? Now, for the sake of completeness, I am doing this just for the sake of completeness. This is not because I want to invade people. I really prefer to invite people into my world to fight them. Ow. Yeah! Oh, I love that backflip so much. Red eye orb and dark mask. Well, that answers the question, what was below there? Online play other. Invade other worlds at will. Defeat the host of embers of the world you have invaded to gain the strength of fire. That is, to gain your ember back. The red eye orb is rooted in a tiny land swallowed by darkness long ago. Some choose to put the orb to other uses. To embark on this path, enter the service of Rosaria in the Cathedral of the Deep. Whoever she is, but okay. I haven't met Rosaria yet. She's probably in an area that I can't get to because I don't know how to lift up the gates that Patch has lowered. I haven't found the switch. I haven't looked for the switch for that, honestly. That was a relatively easy fight. Was I supposed to do something besides kill Yorm in order to get that? Well, at any rate. Wait, hang on. Ow! It occurs to me, before I leave, let's just double check that there's not anything here I can do besides that I've already done and attempted suicides. I apparently cannot. Okay. I don't know, maybe there's another locked door in here or something. I mean, there's just a dark... What is it called? Not a dark star. A dark wraith just sitting here. That's all they're doing. They're just sitting here. Why are they just sitting here? I don't know. I mean, no one's invading me, so I have no clue. But it looks like it's nothing. It also looks like a lot of people had a hard time dealing with it. Well, yeah, I mean, they aren't... Dark Wraiths aren't easy. I just kind of got the jump on it. That, and I'm using a weapon that allowed me to just flip over it and smash it in the face. Anyhow, I think we're done at the High Wall of Lothric. That was the one last section that I wanted to deal with. Although I realize there's like the boss fight, the second boss fight here. But I don't think that's a problem right now. That'll come up when it comes up. As it is right now, I actually have quite a few places in Irithyll I want to deal with. I mean, there's a lot of places, come to think of it, in both... Well, not the Profane Capital. I think the Profane Capital I've pretty well explored. That seems to be relatively done. But was Irithyll Dungeon fully explored? Hmm. Yeah, probably. I can't think of anywhere else I'm missing. Well, I guess we're going back to Irithyll then. Hmm. Probably the Church of Yorshka bonfire. The one we met Anri at. I mean, I've leveled up a bit. My character, at least. Not sure if I've leveled myself up, but I leveled up the character, at least. What? That was an area that I saw that I kind of ignored, but I'm pretty sure that was just the path to Yorm. I mean, come to think of it, there's a lot of places that I've seen that I probably just ignored. What's up here? Oh. This is new. Okay, I'm trying to think where I am right now. So, down there was a little path I ran off to. A couple windows, a couple beams. Is there anything I'm missing for access to the top section? It's not obvious. Because, I mean, that's Irithyll proper. And down there is the path that led to the whole Church of Yorshka and that big beam area that was kind of like one of the early areas in Central Yharnam in Bloodborne. And, I mean, that is one of the many areas I've been to so far. And, of course, back here was some invisible hollows and not-so-invisible hollows, like this one here. It has become considerably easier. And I know there's some of the invisible ones around here. But I can't see them. Oh, wait. There you are. Which I can two-shot now. And what else is there? The dogs. There's the dogs. That's how you pronounce it. The dogs. And down there was the path to Irithyll Dungeon. I don't care about the dogs, though. I also don't really care about the path to Irithyll Dungeon, come to think of it. I've already been there. Hey, invisible monster. Bye, invisible monster. Okay, I think this area is probably fairly fruitless at the moment. Yeah, the only things I can think of are the paths to the profane capital that I took. And I'm pretty sure I took all of them. So, yeah. Back up to Irithyll, back up to that crummy section I didn't want to deal with the Pontiff Knights that I find a pain in the ass. Because they are. That's not supposed to be there. That is. That's actually correct. I've been finding it rather strange. In many areas, you know, I am supposed to cast a shadow, right? Like, I have shadow quality at max. This has been bugging me for a while, actually. Like, I mean, I suppose if I pull out a torch... No, I still don't cast a shadow. I find this very strange. Okay, I don't know. There's got to be something going wrong here. Whatever. Doesn't really matter. Point is, we... Wow, where'd my frame rate go? Point is, we have Pontiff Knights. We have the Fire Witches. And we have a really good vantage point to deal with them from. Yeah. Okay. Got the jump. Fire Witch armor. Side out for a bit. Fire Witch armor. Where's Fire? Okay. All right. I think I've already read this. How does it look, though? That's some fancy stuff. How much? What's the? I didn't even look at any of the stats on it. I'm actually overweight. Very slightly, but that looks cool. Oh yeah, this is heavy. This is a very heavy choice. Oops. I mean, ultimately, I wanted to lead knight armor, but wow, that's... Oh, wait, no. Sorcerer hat stays. Drang gauntlets might change. Are there any? No, there are no options that let me go below the weight limit. No. What happens if I Havel's ring? I don't really want to, but if I Havel's ring, then I'm good. And actually, if I Havel's ring, I might as well bump up. Okay, I want to go something that's a little bit better for strike. So right now, strike is going to kill me. All right, that'll work. Although I have a bit less life, sadly. But I can fast roll, and I look awesome! Although, like I said, I will be switching over to Elite Knight if and when I find it, because that's what I ultimately want for the character, but... Ow! That hurt. I'm gonna heal up and then backstab you to get my mana back. I hope. Or actually, I mean, forget backstab, front stab! Oh yeah, actually that's a one-shot kill now. Oh, no it's not. That's almost a one-shot kill, it's like one health left. Wow. Hey, lightning gem, nice, I can make lightning weapons now. Probably back to Dark Souls 1 lightning weapons where they don't scale, unlike Dark Souls 2 where they did, with faith. Anyway, a gem of infused titanite found in the aftermath of the dragon hunts. Used an infusion to create lightning weapons. Lightning weapons inflict lightning damage and scale with faith! Nice! They do scale with faith. Okay, so fire does not scale. Chaos works... So, fire works like Dark Souls 1 fire, where it doesn't scale at all. Straight damage. Chaos works like Dark Souls 2 fire, where it scales with intelligence plus faith. And, yeah, I guess dark... Deep and dark are the same thing, where deep works like Dark Souls 1, although Dark Souls 1 didn't have a dark scaling. And then... Dark works like Dark Souls 2, where presumably it scales with the minimum of intelligence and faith. I always like that bit. I don't know if I mentioned it before, that I always really like... Yeah, I really like the thematic element of the way Dark Souls 2's weapon scale... Or rather, dark and fire scaling work. Because in Dark Souls 2, dark scales with the minimum of intelligence and faith, while fire scales with their sum. The cool thing about this is that someone who's really good at dark is naturally really good at fire. But not necessarily vice versa. I'm not quite sure if that's meant to mean anything, but just given the connection between dark and fire in the Dark Souls series, the fact that being a good dark mage, being a good hexer, also makes you a good pyromancer, the fact that fire is just essentially kind of weaker than dark, raises some interesting questions about the nature of the world and... Oh, nice. Okay, magic clutch ring, that's lowered physical defense for increased magic damage. But yeah, it raises interesting questions about how you actually get fire, if fire is kind of subordinate dark, or dark is a stronger thing. Ow. Aw, seriously? Doesn't open from this side? Well, what side does it open from then? Because... I'm feeling kind of stuck. Okay, so we have that balcony up there. That's clearly how you get down to there. And the lower area there we were just in. So that does not help. Oh! How do I get over there? Like, I see where I'm supposed to go. I just need to figure out how to get there now. Ideally without dying. This is another that doesn't open to the side. Yes, it is. Although my enemies have mostly moved away. Alright. I think we're going to have to run through them. Although I know that in one case, I can deal with this Fire Witch without dealing with the Fire Witch. Ow. And now they're after me. Are they onto me? Hang on, did I miss something? Shoot, I missed something. That area is not directly accessible, is it? And the leggings. I like my skirt, but I'm a bit curious about this. How does it look? No, I'm gonna go with my old one. And I guess the gold trim goes with the gold. Yeah, it does kind of go together. Okay. Ah, what the heck? Fine. Come at me and I kill you. Ow. Okay. Well, your little mook there isn't gonna be of much help. Okay, got it. Oh yeah, I got the backstab. Got my magic back. And got the meaty strong attack. This is working out better than the first time through, I can tell you that much. Wow, you actually got me with that. You're learning. I'm impressed. I'm also wondering where the heck that anything is, honestly. Oh, wait, these are the fire witches I was... Okay, fire... Ow! Right, right, that attack. I forgot about that. Pleasantly. Ow. Whatever. You're down. Just got some magic back from an earlier backstab. Let's use that to heal up. Another fire which is on its way up. First are on their way down. Okay, these patrol routes are getting a bit annoying, but I think I can... Alright, I'm gonna do this. The problem with the Fire Witches, of course, is that they have the ranged attack. The other two are fine. Like, the other types of Pontiff Knights, they're fine. I can deal with them relatively easily. And the Fire Witches I can deal with on their own. This Fire Witch is supported by the melee assholes. That's when the problems come. Okay, I think I've got enough room. Alright. Okay, that was easy enough. And you guys down too. All right, great. Because the question is, of course, how do I get down there? There's this whole area down there, and I can't figure out how to get to it. Yeah, that's the area I was hanging out in. Actually, up there was the area I was hanging out in, right here. I wanted to get down here. No clear direct path how to do it. Although I am very proud of myself that I'm able to now get through those enemies. Granted that part of it is because my equipment is better. And part of it is that my character has been leveled up. But part of that seems to be also that I'm just a lot more confident at dealing with those enemies. Still a pain in the butt, but I feel like Irithyll Dungeon did me some good in getting used to some of the more aggressive enemies. I mean, granted, jailers weren't as aggressive, but... You let them alone for 2 seconds, and you paid for it. Hard. So, there is that. Anyhow. I don't know. This is really weird. I wonder if that... I mean, I remember I found that section right at the start of the episode, or near the start of the episode. I mean, at the start of the episode was obviously Yorm. Near the start of the episode with the rafters and the beams and all that. Does not seem to be relevant. I find this annoying. Yeah, because you went in here. And I went up here. And that brought me to this octagonal room of no apparent consequence yet. Which corresponds, if I were to go outside, gonna be doing some exploring here. If we were to go outside, actually I'm testing for secrets. No secrets, apparently, not I can find. But yeah, if we go back outside, then we'll find... Wait, where's the place? Oh, it's behind, right, yeah. Which means I can't easily find it from here. Yeah, I think it's that church tower over there. Like, this church tower right here. And that's here I can't access from this side. Alright, I'm going to cut until I find something useful, although I may end up just ending the episode pretty soon because I don't know where I'm supposed to go at this point. Unless this is the point where I'm supposed to go back to the High Wall of Lothric in order to find the... Well, I guess you didn't see it, but there's another boss in the High Wall of Lothric that I haven't fought yet that wasn't attacking me. Probably if I attacked the woman who gave me the Way of Blue Covenant. Actually, I know that it would cause the boss fight to happen. But I'm not going to attack her. I'm also not going to go there quite yet. What I am going to do is go down to the dungeon entrance. Because what I want to know is, did I miss anything over... Or just Distant Manor, even. Because the dungeon entrance was a bit different. Distant Manor involved running through a bunch of water. That may actually provide me with... Yeah, because this is the Distant Manor. I got in through here, the lake. And getting through the lake was after the section I was trying to avoid, which was just the... What was it called? Oh, right, yeah, the Church of Yorshka. So getting to the Church of Yorshka, going through here. I knew I'd seen those before. The Canehurst things that I mentioned before. Those that are down in the Profane Capital. You're toxic to me. Thankfully you're not living in toxic like you would like your brethren downstairs, but holy. That's annoying. Very mildly annoying, but annoying nonetheless. I feel insulted. Right, this area. Okay. And you're just invisible annoyance. Okay, I'm gonna have to heal up. You made me have to heal up. There we go. A lot of invisible enemies in 3. Dark Souls 3. Seems to be a bit of a theme. Oh, right. This is the church proper, which I don't really care to run through. So, what did I miss? Because there's a shortcut down to the area, the opening bonfire. I was actually looking for it before, and I couldn't find it. And I still can't. Ow. That was annoying. Anyway, yeah, I don't know.
What is wrong? Are you not a lord?
Nope. Not here. Not yet. Not unless I kill her. Well, attack her. Alright, back in Irithyll. Explored around a bit the cathedral, explored around a bit in Lothric. Actually, you saw the Lothric part. You probably saw the cathedral part. And now I'm back here. Because as far as I can tell, this is the only way to go. That doesn't involve blindly attacking NPCs, at least. So, we'll see how this goes. Kind of hoping it'll go better than before. Ow! How is it faster than me? Hmm. At least there are no souls that I really lost. Hey. I mean, granted, I just leveled up because I ran through the cathedral again, like from start to finish. Why am I going through this? No, oh, I'll just rest the bonfire over there. I ran through the cathedral start to finish, and I couldn't find any other levers. So I don't know. My guess is that there's another path that I missed that's like around the back, like that either I missed or I can't get to yet. That's just around the back, which really disappoints me. I feel like I should have just killed Patches before anything happened. Oh well. Hopefully I'll find out one day what I'm supposed to do there. Today is not that day, but hopefully one day I will. And my 8 souls, and also picking up whatever this is, which is another weary warrior soul, and... No. I never actually did check out this balcony area that the weary warrior soul was at. Ow. You done? Okay, I'm forgetting how to fight these things now. All of a sudden. I'm also tired. That's like... Shorter episode. Yeah, this is going to be a shorter episode. What do you have now? More Pond of Night Armor. Alright, I think I already have that one. Don't really care. So what I care about in going through this way is that I wonder if I missed a path that I'm missing because I'm not going back and not checking out round back, but I think I've found everything. Is everything to be reasonably obvious? I don't know. I mean, if someone else knows, this is a time where I actually would accept a tiny bit of spoilers as to where the heck do I go now? Because I have got no clue. Seriously, I have no idea what to do. Is this a path I could take? Is this a path I could take? None of these look like paths I could take. I expect I'm gonna have to fall off something, I just don't know where. Or if that's even the right track to go off at all. And I kinda suspect it isn't. Ow. Thank you. Now, I'm fairly certain, as I recall, I cannot backstab these enemies. There's another claymore. No, blood gem. Okay. Now, the reason I'm double-checking this, too, is because I'm much more confident about dealing with Urithel. First time I went through this, I had no confidence. I was not at all sure I could do this, and I was pretty confident I could not. However, that situation has changed. And as a result, I feel like there's a lot more I can get out of just trying to explore around the place, killing off Pontiff Knights, killing off Fire Witches, and all that. And then ultimately finding the next path, which I'm assuming I can get to right now. I don't have to go through an alternate route. But I don't know. That's merely an assumption on my part. That's not actually something I have managed to verify at this point. I do not want to deal with Pontiff Knights in groups. And I know how to get around some of them, but I was like, there's no way to drop. There's no way over these rooftops. Like, I want to get over there, but I don't know how. And that bugs me. A lot. No, that's not a path down. Not a path around. This is not even a path. Where do I go? Like, is there a secret I missed? This is a secret wall? No. I don't know. I think I'm gonna have to end the episode here. I'll go back to Urithel Dungeon and just put myself into a slightly less precarious position right now, and then end the episode, because as far as I can tell, I'm once again kind of stuck. And if it's anything like last time, I just missed some path somewhere. Anyway, that's that. So the next one, I guess we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.